Well, to find the Higgs would tell us we were really on the right track. We imagined there should be a Higgs boson to explain why the fundamental interactions we have seen so far have the properties they do, without any real experimental indication that such a thing could exist. In fact, the Higgs is so different than other particles, I'm not sure we would even have recognized the indications. And to have predicted such a thing based purely on mathematical elegance and then find it shows that we're really on the right track, that our models are really telling us something deep down about how the universe works.
And if you were to compare it to another field outside of physics, how big a deal could you describe the Higgs as?
Oh, that's very difficult to answer because, you know, once we find the Higgs, we will have sort of completed the standard model of particle physics. And we sort of, you know, we've been working with that now for many years, more than 30 years. To know how big an effect that will have, we know that the standard model can't be complete. There's just too many things in the standard model which are just pulled out of the air, right? Why are there three generations? Why are the masses what they are, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. There's so many things that don't make sense. So we know the standard model has to be embedded into some much bigger model of physics. And once we find what that is, all right, we'll have a much bigger, better appreciation of how the different parts fit together. So I guess I would answer the way Deng Xiaoping answered when Henry Kissinger asked him what he thought of the French Revolution. He said, it's a little too early to tell.
Many people would feel, well, we found the Higgs now. That's the end for the LHC, isn't it? What would you say to that?
When Christopher Columbus landed in the New World, did he go, oh, that's nice, and turn around and go back? Just because you have found some events in the LHC that decay, like you expect for a Higgs boson, in the LHC, you don't collide two protons and have a thing that jumps out with a big sign on it that says, I am a Higgs boson, right? What you see are particles in your detector, which are, you know, the products of decay of something. And what you have to do is steadily refine your measurements of the properties of that something to see if it really does look like the Higgs boson. Okay, you could easily imagine, and theorists have come up with hundreds of models of particles that look a bit like the Higgs boson, but when you look at them in detail, they're not the Higgs boson, or they don't have all the properties you would imagine for the Higgs boson. It will take many, many, many years with the LHC to get a large enough sample of these particles for us to begin to look in detail and see, does this thing really look like the Higgs or not?
And why is it so important to look for the Higgs, to study beyond that, in your opinion?
Well, you know, this is just the question of why we do fundamental physics, right? We're trying to understand the most fundamental rules that govern the universe. And historically, when you discover new fundamental rules that govern the universe, in time, it leads you, through your better understanding of the universe, to more control over that universe. Now, I don't think you're going to have an automobile running on Higgs bosons, probably ever, but certainly no time in my lifetime or even your grandkids' lifetime. The point is not that you have an immediate technological spin-off of that immediate discovery. It's that the overall understanding of fundamental physics almost invariably leads, in the end, to technological revolutions.